Hey guys, this is Austin, and today I'm here with a tutorial showing you how to get the Xbox One controller working on your PC. While up until now there hasn't been any official support for the Xbox One controller on Windows, Microsoft just released a driver to make it happen. While any Xbox One controller will work, the only downside is that you have to keep it wired. Now this isn't a big deal in my opinion, however you won't be able to use a wireless adapter like you were able to do with the 360 controller. Just grab a micro USB cable and plug it into the controller and your PC. Soon Windows will automatically include the drivers built in, but for now head over to Major Nelson's blog, which I'll have linked in the description, and download the drivers for either 32 or 64-bit Windows. I tested on Windows 8.1 and had no problems, however some people are seeing issues on Windows 7 and especially on Vista, which I guess makes sense considering that I don't believe Vista is supported just yet. Since these just came out, Windows gave me a smart screen warning when I went to install, but this driver comes straight from Microsoft, so if you see this, just ignore it and continue. From here, it's as simple as just clicking through the installer and that's it, no restart required. If you jump into Device Manager, you'll see that the new controller is recognized just that quickly. The way things work is that the Xbox One controller pretends that it's actually a 360 controller. That means that any game that uses the 360 controller as an option should work just fine here. Jump into Watch Dogs and the game immediately recognizes the Xbox One gamepad. There's literally no setup, everything just works. Since the button layout is basically the same as on the 360, changes like the better D-pad and bigger triggers are a nice improvement. I tried a few other games with no problems, Left 4 Dead 2 being the only title that was just a little off. Even here though, it's not a big deal, as it just needs a quick adjustment of the controller sensitivity and things are solid. I really like the Xbox One controller, and I'm impressed with how seamlessly it works on the PC. If a game worked with a 360 controller, it'll work here. So what do you guys think? Are you planning on picking up an Xbox One controller for your PC? Let me know in the comments below. Anyway guys, thank you so much for watching, and I will catch you in the next one.